I shall continue the topic of geodesics and hanging chain problem in calculus of variations. This is in 18 MAT 31 lecture series, that is VTU e-Sikshana program, that is P4, and this is module 5. What is the meaning of geodesic in calculus of variations? Suppose we have any curved surface that is shortest possible distance between any two points on the curved surface, that is to be calculated using the application of calculus of variations. This is nothing but standard variational problem in geodesic. Referring to the shortest possible distance between two points on the curved surface means two good examples we shall discuss in this topic. One is cylindrical polar coordinates for the right circular cylinder, and one more is spherical polar coordinate systems. Let me define what exactly this geodesic in the calculus of variation. The definition is like this. In geodesic, on a surface, a geodesic on a surface is a curve along which the distance between any two points on a curved surface, any two points on the curved surface, to find the geodesic on a surface is a variational problem involving conditional extrema. Here one special case, geodesic on a plane is a straight line but on the curved surface, that will be the shortest possible distance. We say that that line will be measured on the curved surface, but on the plane it is a straight line. Okay, so now what is the geodesic with reference to the right circular cylinder and with respect to spherical polar coordinate system? Let us take an example. To find the geodesic on right circular cylinder, the example is like this. Find the geodesic on a right circular cylinder radius A. What is the meaning of right circular cylinder? This is the figure which I am referring to, right circular cylinder. This is the diameter. For example, A, O, B, and this is C, for example, then this angle should be 90 degree. That means the vertical line inside the right circular cylinder for the baseline, this baseline is AB. AB is nothing but diameter equal to capital D. If you take, then OB is equal to radius equal to A. That means in the right circular cylinder, the diameter is B, AB is equal to D, and OB is equal to A. Here it is given right circular cylinder of radius A units. Now, what are the coordinates in the right circular cylinder? That means the geometry is to be referred from Cartesian to the standard cylindrical polar coordinate system. This is a right circular cylinder, means this line should be perpendicular to the baseline, the angle should be 90 degree. This is called right circular cylinder. Okay, then the line when it makes 90 degree, then we consider, this is just like for example, this is a cylinder. If you assume this is a cylinder, okay, this is a cylinder, then any two points on this curved surface we take, then we, by the application of this calculus of variations, we have to find out the geodesic. It is the shortest possible distance on the curved surface. Now we are referring to the right circular cylinder. Now what we do here, in the right circular cylinder, we have to define the coordinate x, y, z be the Cartesian coordinates. Cartesian coordinates such that r, phi, z are rho, phi, z be the cylindrical polar coordinates, cylindrical polar coordinates such that this r is the radius, that is r is equal to A, is equal to another notation which we can take. Then the standard transformations in cylindrical polar coordinate system are x equal to, these values are given by r cos phi, and y is equal to r sin phi, and z is equal to z. R means rho cos phi, this is rho sin phi, and z equal to z. These are the standard cylindrical polar coordinate transformations. This is Cartesian polar coordinate system, and this is polar coordinate system. But with reference to cylindrical right circular cylinder, these are the cylindrical polar coordinates, but the transformation between Cartesian to cylindrical polar coordinate system are these values. X is a function of r and phi, and y is a function of r and phi, and z is function of z itself. These are the standard cylindrical polar coordinate transformations from Cartesian to cylindrical system. Now, from the orthogonal curvilinear coordinates, we have what is the value of this when we consider on the right circular cylinder. into points, that those points will be joined, that is P x1, y1, z1, otherwise r1, phi1, z1, and this is Q, that is r2, phi2, and z2. This is the length, total length of the indicated end, first point and last point, but the arc we consider this one as delta S, otherwise ds on the cylindrical system. Then how this is defined in orthogonal curvilinear coordinates, that you can refer to the vector calculus. We have discussed in detail about three types of OCC, we call them, that is orthogonal curvilinear coordinates. Then those orthogonal curvilinear coordinates in the cylindrical polar coordinate system are given by, what is the value of this derivative, that is ds square is equal to dx whole square plus dy whole square plus dz whole square. Then we have this in by, we can write OCC, orthogonal curvilinear coordinates, that is ds whole square is equal to d rho whole square plus rho into d phi whole square plus dz whole square. This is in the orthogonal curvilinear coordinates. The length of the arc, that is ds whole square, is equal to summation of these three values. Then d rho, that means d rho means radius is a units. Then what is the differentiation? Then that is the radius is constant, that is a is equal to constant, it's a numerical value. Here rho is equal to r, that is equal to a, it is constant, it is constant, implies that is d rho, that is dr, that is equal to 0. This value is 0. When we consider this one, rho itself is, that is the constant value. Constant value means differentiation itself also becomes constant, because radius is in terms of the numerical value, then it must be constant. Therefore, rho is equal to r is equal to a into constant. This term becomes 0. ds whole square, that is equal to 0, plus of rho into, that is a square content, that is d phi whole square, plus of, it is dz whole square. Therefore, a square plus d phi whole square plus of dz whole square. Then, what is the conversion, otherwise what is the transformation we have to consider? That means, a transformation means we have to consider the arc square, derivative of the arc square, and we have to consider the value of that derivative whole square is equal to 0 in place of d rho square plus rho into d phi whole square plus of dz whole square. Then how we have to take this value further in order to represent the shortest possible distance in terms of arc length whole square, that is equal to a square d phi, that is whole square, plus of dz, that is whole square. This is ds whole square. Then ds divided by, it is d phi whole square, that means I am dividing by, dividing by, it is d phi whole square, dividing by d phi whole square, dividing by d phi whole square means here this becomes a square plus of dz divided by, it is d phi whole square. So ds divided by d phi whole square, that is equal to a square plus dz by d
d5 whole square. Then what is ds? That means ds divided by d5 is equal to plus or minus square root of a square plus of, I can write this one as z dash whole square, because what is that z dash? Where z dash is equal to dz divided by, it is d5. That should be instead of y dash we have, it is z dash. That means dz by d5 whole square. Then what is ds? Taking this plus sign for the representation of the curve, only ds we consider. What is that ds? Your ds is equal to square root of a square plus, that is z dash, it should be whole square, into d5. Now integrate between phi 1 to phi 2. That means d5 is there. Then left side integration ds gives us s only, that is phi 1 to phi 2 square root of a square plus of z dash whole square. This is d5. Then why we have to compare with the Euler's equation? Therefore, to find the extremal, we have to compare with the Euler's equation, and the derivative we have to collect and we have to analyze that given function. Otherwise, the function appears under the integral sign is independent of which variable. So that how we have to proceed in order to consider the derivative for further integration. Then, what is the term we have here under the integration? That is nothing but a function. That means extremal. Okay, that is extremal. Then we can take here f equal to square root of a square plus of, it is z dash whole square. F is equal to a square plus z dash whole square implies here f is not containing, that is phi. Therefore, del f divided by del y, nothing but del f divided by del phi is equal to 0, because that term is not there. Then another term which we have to consider, that is del f divided by del y dash, that is nothing but del f divided by, it is del z dash is equal to del y, it is del z, del y del z dash of root of, that is a square plus of z dash whole square. Okay, then what we have to consider? We have to differentiate this. That is root of a square plus z dash whole square is nothing but 1 divided by a square plus z dash, it is whole square, into 2 times z dash. That is differentiation as it is, that is root of something and differentiation inside. That is 2 cancels, then del f divided by del z dash, that is equal to z dash divided by square root of a square plus of, it is z dash whole square. This is the value of del f by del z dash. Next, how we have to proceed? That is del f by del z dash we have to take for the integration. Then we have to analyze this function, which is independent of which quantity? It is independent of what? Which quantity? This is independent of y. Then the another term must be taken as constant. Here f is independent of y, that is nothing but of phi. Then when it is independent of y, del f divided by del z dash that is equal to constant. We can take it as C, and this is already calculated, del f by del z dash, that is equal to z dash divided by root of a square plus of, it is z dash whole square. Then we have to discuss the simplification of getting the function z in terms of another symbol. Okay, that is nothing but z dash, this one. We can take only the constant comparison, therefore taking z dash equal to c into root of, that is a square plus of z dash whole square. So z dash is equal to constant into, that is taking cross multiplication, then z dash is defined like this. Further, what we can do, we have to solve for z. Solve for z means we have to rearrange the term by the removal of square root sign. By the removal of square root sign means we have to square on both sides, and then z dash square, we have to take that term as common, and then we have to discuss. That is, left z dash whole square, that is equal to, this one will be c square into a square plus of, it is z dash whole square. Okay, then z dash whole square and c square into z dash whole square, I will take this term to the left side. Then 1 minus c square into, that is z dash whole square, that is equal to c square into a square. C square into a square, otherwise we can write here, it is c square a square plus of c square into, it is z dash whole square. Then z dash whole square is equal to c square a square, that is divided by 1 minus, it is c square. What is this z dash whole square? Z dash only you can take, then right side is square root of that term. How we have to take that? Dz, that is z dash is equal to plus or minus, that is root of c square a square divided by 1 minus of c square. What is this? C into a, c into a, then what you have to take? Denominator square root of 1 minus c square. Only plus sign we are considering. Plus sign we are, that means taking plus sign, positive quantity, taking plus sign, we can write z dash like this. Then what is z dash actually? Z dash is nothing but dz divided by, it is d phi, that is nothing but ca divided by square root of 1 minus c square. This implies dz is equal to ca divided by square root of 1 minus c square multiplied by, it is d phi. Then to calculate z only from this dz, we take the integration on both sides. So we can write integrating on both sides, integrating on both sides should be z is equal to, that is integration c into a over square root of 1 minus c square, that should be d phi. Then plus of some other constant, that is let us say c1. Then what is on the right side? That is equal to this integration of, this is integration, this quantity is constant, that is ca divided by square root of 1 minus c square is constant, then the integration of this d phi, this comes to be integration of d phi is phi, and c1 as it is. Therefore this quantity ca divided by square root of 1 minus c square, because d phi is the variable, then it must be phi integration and plus C1. This, if you want to write this total constant, because C is constant, A is constant, the whole thing becomes constant. This is capital A into phi plus of capital B, you can write, where A equal to C into A over root of 1 minus, it is C square, and capital B is equal to what? It is C1. So this is what the required geodesic, and which is the shortest distance possible. Okay, which is the required, which is the required shortest possible, shortest possible distance on the cylindrical surface, on the cylindrical surface. So which is the shortest possible distance on cylindrical surface means z degree is 1 and phi degree is 1, z equal to a into phi plus b. So this is the quantity, it is nothing but linear equation, first degree in z and first degree in phi. It is nothing but linear equation for cylindrical right circular cylinder. When we consider any two points on the cylindrical surface, then geodesic is nothing but shortest possible distance which connects between two points on the curved surface. Let us discuss another situation, that is with respect to the spherical polar coordinates. What is the shortest possible distance, which we call it as a great circle? Then the equation how we will get at the end, the same, applying the same procedure, then we have to define what are the transformations from Cartesian to the spherical polar coordinate system. Then we need to define those values, and then we have to use Euler's equation. Then another example I will write. Example is like this. Show that the geodesic on a sphere, geodesics on a sphere of radius. On a radius A or its great circles. This is also a curved surface, that is a sphere. This is also a curved surface. We look at two points like x1, y1, z1, and and x2, y2, z2. Any two points on the spherical surface. So that is also a curved surface. Then we connect these two points, and then we will expect what is the shortest possible distance between these two points. Then, what is that shortest possible distance here? How this shortest distance or possible distance will be defined? Let us see. Okay, in the solution, let x equal to r sine theta, that is cos phi, and y is equal to r sine theta and sine phi, and z equal to r cos theta. This clearly indicates x, y, z are transforming into, that is, r theta and phi. These are the
spherical polar coordinates. These are the Cartesian coordinates. These are the spherical polar coordinates.
The standard transformations between these two will be x equal to r sin theta cos phi, y is equal to r sin theta sin phi, z equal to r cos theta. Again by OCC, by orthogonal curvilinear coordinates, we have, that is, arc length, we take that as ds, where s is the total length of the curve, as ds square, ds whole square is equal to dr whole square plus r into d theta whole square plus of r sin theta, that is d phi, it is whole square. Here, what is the radius? Radius is a. That means r equal to a, the radius. Then its derivative is nothing but dr, that is equal to 0. R equal to a, the radius, that is equal to 0. Then dr equal to 0 means ds whole square, this is 0, plus of, that is equal to 0, plus of, in place of r you are putting it as a, that is a square, it is d theta whole square, plus of a square, that is sin square theta, and d phi, that is whole square. Then we can take a square outside, and a square outside, and dividing by here also may do the same thing, d phi whole square. Then ds divided by, it is d phi whole square, should be a square is common, and that is here dr, d theta, and d theta, that is ds by d theta, and a square, that is dividing by, is not d phi, this is d theta, d theta, here also theta, then a square, here becomes, that is 1 into, and plus of, that is a square sin square theta, and d phi by, d phi by d theta. Then you can take a square common on the RHS. That should be ds divided by d theta whole square. That should be a square into 1 plus, it is sin square theta into d phi divided by d theta, d phi divided by d theta whole square. Then d phi, this is ds by d theta. Here also we do the same thing, that is ds by d theta equal to plus or minus a into root of, that is here square means we are removing that, 1 plus of sin square theta, and d phi divided by, it is d theta whole square. Taking only the plus sign from the RHS, that is equal to, that is equal to plus or minus, that means a times, then square root of 1 plus of, that is sin square theta, and we can call this one as phi dash whole square. That is phi dash whole square we can take, that is d phi by d theta. Then this can be taken as, that is ds, and right side, that is into d theta. Otherwise f we can take, that means s is equal to integrating, that is between what? Integrating between theta 1, integrating between theta 1 to theta 2. Then S is equal to A into integration, that is theta 1 to theta 2 square root of 1 plus, it is sin square theta, and phi dash, it is whole square, should be d theta. Then, so that is A into this much, we can take it as function as per the extremal. This implies, let f is equal to A into, that means function under the integral sign, this is the total function along with A, 1 plus of, should be sin square theta into, it is phi dash whole square. So, after writing this f is equal to A into square root of something, this clearly indicates f is independent of y. F is independent of y.
F is independent of y means
we can take this one.
F is independent of y, we can take this one as, that is, here the symbol y in place of y, that is phi is there. Okay, then independent of y, that implies
del f divided by, it is del phi dash is equal to constant.
Del f divided by del phi, that is equal to
constant. Then when it is constant, then we have to take the derivative of that as it is, that is del f divided by, it is del phi dash, phi dash, that is equal to del by del phi dash of that quantity, that is A times square root of, that is 1 plus sin square, 1 plus sin square theta, that is phi dash square.
1 plus sin square theta, that is phi dash square.
Then this value with respect to phi dash we have to differentiate, that is del f by del phi dash, and this value is equal to constant. We take that constant as something like c. Therefore, what is the value of f? Then we have to consider that is equal to constant, and we will differentiate this quantity with respect to phi dash. That implies we have to differentiate this with respect to phi dash means A. Square root of this means 1 divided by, it is 2 root of 1 plus sin square theta into phi dash square, and that is 1 divided by 2 root of this, and differentiation inside with respect to phi dash, that is 2 times of sin square theta into phi dash, that is equal to c. Then this 2 cancels, then we can consider this one, that is sin square phi into phi dash. Okay, then only phi dash you take to the left side. Afterwards you can think of this sin square theta, otherwise phi dash will be separated either to the right side or to the left side. Okay, let me take like this. It is phi dash this is equal to phi dash, that is equal to d phi divided by d theta, that is equal to, it should be c by a into, so this comes to be to the denominator. Okay, this comes to be to the denominator means phi dash square del f divided by del phi dash, this much, that is equal to constant. Then
After taking the differentiation, then we can take the cross multiplication here, that is del phi divided by del theta, del phi divided by phi dash means del phi, otherwise phi dash is there, let us keep like that only. Then this one will be c by a into, this comes to denominator, that is sin square theta, it is phi dash, and this is square root of 1 plus sin square theta, and then it is phi dash. Then here it is equal to constant, that value we have taken it as a constant. So what we have to take, that is c by a, therefore sin square theta into phi dash, then that is equal to c by a, and this is d phi by d theta. So here itself we could have taken, that is a into, from this step also we can write, that is a into, it is sin square theta and phi dash, that is equal to c into square root of, that is 1 plus, it will be 1 plus sin square theta, 1 plus sin square theta into phi dash whole square. Then this is sin square theta is there, this should be a square, and sin to the power 4 theta, that is phi dash square, the sin to the power 4 theta, if we make square on both sides, c square into 1 plus, it is sin square theta into phi dash, it is whole square. Then you can take that is phi dash square, this term comes to the denominator. Phi dash square, and then you can collect the common coefficients from LHS to RHS. That is phi dash square is here and phi dash square is here. Therefore, phi dash square multiplied by, what is that? A square sin to the power 4 theta, and if you take to the left side, minus of C square, that is sin square theta, and that is equal to c square. Then phi dash square is equal to c square divided by, it is sin square theta I can take common, then a square sin square theta minus of, it is c square. Sin square a square sin square theta minus of c square. Then what we have to do, that is left side, anyway we have to take the square root sign of this in order to avoid this square in the left side. Then phi dash only we have to take, that is equal to c divided by, that is sin theta multiplied by, it is square root of a square, it is sin square theta minus of, it is c square. Okay, minus of c square, this is nothing but phi dash. Then what is phi dash? Should be d phi by, it is d theta, c divided by, it is sin theta multiplied to square root of a square sin square theta minus of, it is c square. Then what is sin, that is sin theta, and if you take sin square outside, okay, then from these two, sin square if you take outside, anyway we have to arrange for integration, that is c into 1 divided by sin theta. I am taking this sin square theta outside the square root sign, this is one more sin theta, inside the square root sign,
that is a square, okay, a square minus of it is c square divided by it is sin square theta. Then what is this? We can write here itself, that is equal to c divided by sin into sin, sin square, 1 by sin square means we can write it as that is cosecant square, that is c square, square root of this, then cosecant square theta, and divided by this must be written as a square minus c square, this is also it is cosecant square theta. Then let me express this cosecant theta in terms of cot theta. What is that cosecant theta? That is d phi by it is d theta, d phi by d theta, that is equal to c into cosecant square theta divided by, inside the denominator only you change that is r square root of, that is a square minus of c square into 1 plus it is cot square theta, because for the integration purpose we rearrange the terms like this, okay, that is cot square theta. Then what we have to take when we convert this in the form of right side, that is numerator cosecant and denominator cot, means we can go for the substitution method for integration. Then what is that 1 plus cot square multiplied by c square? We have to rearrange, that is c cosecant square theta divided by square root of, that is a square minus c square, and minus of c square it is cot square theta. Then a square minus c square is constant, that total quantity is constant, and from that again c square is there, that we will replace, that is equal to c cosecant square theta, c cosecant square theta divided by a square minus c square under root, a square minus c square, and c square I am taking outside, that is c square here, and minus of that is cot square theta, and outside the square root sign is c, this cancels. Then that is cosecant square theta into d theta divided by, that is root of this is constant square means under root, again root you have to write, that is a square minus c square divided by c square, whole square I will take this, minus of it is cot square theta, then only d phi, this is d phi by d theta, but here it is only d phi. Then what is this value? That is cosecant square theta, and we are taking this one for the integration, putting cot theta as some other variable. Okay, next is by substitution integration. How we have to take? Put cot theta is equal to t, then that becomes minus cosecant square theta d theta, that is equal to dt. Therefore d phi is equal to, that is d phi is equal to cosecant square, that is under the integration, this implies phi is equal to integration, that should be cosecant square theta in the numerator and d theta, and in the denominator that is square root under a square minus c square divided by it is c square whole square minus it is cot square theta and plus of constant c1. Therefore this d phi, instead after the integration only phi remains, then phi is equal to, that is integration minus of this into this, we can write it as that is dt with minus sign, dt divided by square root of, divided by square root of, again square root, a square minus c square divided by c square, minus of t square into dt, that is, and plus constant c1. Then the integration of this term will be, that is in terms of sine inverse, because just like it is the formula integration of dx divided by a square minus x square is equal to sine inverse x divided by a, that's the formula. Then phi is equal to, that should be minus sine inverse, minus sine inverse, that is t divided by x divided by a, that must be x divided by a means this is under root, it is whole square, under root whole square, a square sine inverse x by a, that is a square minus c square divided by c square. Okay, so this becomes a is under root, right? Then this becomes minus of, that is plus constant c1. This you can take it to the numerator, square root of this one, that is sine inverse, sine inverse, that is c into t divided by, sorry, sine inverse c into t divided by root of, it is a square minus c square. So this you can put it as, that is minus sine inverse, minus sine inverse, what is that value, c, that is c into t, t means cot theta, cot theta divided by root of a square minus c square, root of a square minus c square and plus of c1. This is the final step of the value, which is phi. What is this phi? Nothing but geodesic, otherwise shortest possible distance, which will be this. If you take rearranging, you will be getting the great circle. That means the great circle, when we want to define, still we have to this one rearrange, and then we have to see that required geodesic in terms of great circle, which is the required, which is the required geodesic, which is the required geodesic for the given spherical polar coordinate system with the radius of a. So this is how we calculate geodesic on the curved surface for cylindrical polar coordinate system and spherical polar coordinate system. So with this, in another session I will discuss about hanging chain problem, and then I will conclude this module 5.